squad to step foot.
You own 17 birds. Big ring, I play for the 17 birds. In my line, if you own 17 birds. Big ring, I play for the 17 birds. I know a guy if you want 17 birds. Big ring, I play for the 17 birds. I know a guy if you want 17 birds. Big ring, I play for the 17 birds. Yeah, I'm from the 17th curb.
Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Lil Brunson back at you with the back at you, and I am the best reporting on the Eagles. Listen, before we get into the meat and potatoes, I got to say thank you to y'all. You know what I'm saying? The gold-plated hurt season snapbacks, 306 hats, all gone in 40 hours, less than 2 days. Shout out to y'all. Each hat individually numbered. Individually numbered for authenticity. 1 out of 306. 2 out of 306. Well, I got 1 out of 306. You know what I mean? And I'm picking two numbers out of the 305 hats, the 305 remaining hats to come with me for opening day when we drop the banner. And the stadium is going to be crazy. Opening day. I hope it's two people that never went, but this is going to be a random selection. It's going to be lit, man. So, yo, man, it's sold out, but, you know, have no fear. Have no fear. I'm going to have something special, special for everybody else so you can get tapped in with that as well. But I will never make another gold-plated metallic thread hurt season hat. So shout out to the Lucky 306, man. You do not want to miss the next drop. The ideas are there, man. The dope merchandise is there for the summer, man. I'm telling y'all, man, it's going to be a whole vibe, a whole vibe, a whole vibe. Let's get into some Eagles news real quick. As we embark on this Super Bowl, you know, we're in the Super Bowl. You know what I mean? A lot of people can't say that, you know. Only two teams can say that. We're in the Super Bowl. And, you know, as we get close to the Super Bowl, we get some crazy news about this dude, Eagles offensive lineman Josh Sills, indicted on a bunch of nasty work I don't even want to talk about for real. I don't even want to say his name. He on the commissioner's exempt list. He's out of here. He's done. He's not a bird. He's not an eagle. Him and that other dude, 445, they can go share the same spot. You know what I mean? They can go share the same cot for all we care about over here. But, you know, get him out of here. That is what it is. Landon Dickerson should be ready to play. Overextended or hyperextended his elbow. You know what I mean? He should be good to go there in that regard. And, you know, we're just getting ready for it, man. The storylines are building. We know about, you know, this Super Bowl being the first Super Bowl with two African-American quarterbacks in it. This Super Bowl will have the two youngest quarterbacks in it. This Super Bowl will have two 14-3 teams. It's crazy. This Super Bowl will consist of the best pass rush win rate versus the best pass block win rate. Strength on strength, man, in all aspects of the game, for real. But they ain't seen us in the wave of guys that we could bring at them. So I think we'll be able to wear them down. It's crazy, man. You know, the emergence of Kenny Gainwell going into the Super Bowl. Devontae Smith coming in his own. A.J. Brown, you know, the development of Jalen Hurts. All these pieces came together beautifully. Howie Roseman was the orchestrator of all of this. You know what I mean? The development of all of these guys, drafting all of these guys. He put this whole mixing pot together of talent, and now you in the Super Bowl, man. It is ridiculousness, man, to even think that this happened as fast as it happened, man. 2 years ago, we was talking about how we got to go. Now we in the Super Bowl. You know what I mean? It's just crazy, man. Crazy. Fred Warner's wife, I'm not sure of her name. Miss Warner, I'm going to just call her that. You know, she has some things to say about, you know, the Philadelphia Eagles fans and how she was treated at the game. It made Sports Illustrated. It made TMZ Sports. You know, she said that it was a hostile environment. You know what I mean? She said that, you know, she feared for her safety. You know, this whole thing that the national media tries to do to Philadelphia fans is just totally unfair at this point. Let's call a spade a spade. They like to talk like we just like from the underworld, or we just don't have no home training when they come here, and it's just that all the stuff that's going on. All that. Listen, a lot of these other organizations, and I heard Levi Stadium, correct me if I'm wrong, I heard they can't even tailgate there. You know what I mean? I heard they can't even, at the AT&T Stadium, you can't tailgate in the parking lot. It got to be on grass. Like, they got rules for their fandom. We don't really have that. And she was saying it was pushing and shoving. Fred Warner was telling her not to wear red. Like, what type of time y'all on, man? Y'all going to a football game. I've been to 50 football games in my life at the Link Vet. You could mix it up. I've never seen a woman get shoved at a football game. I'm not here to discredit her experience or whatever trauma that she thought she felt in the game. But come on, man. Come on, man. It just don't be happening like that, man. Nobody's complaining when these guys come to our city and desecrate the Rocky statue. They go to our museums and do what they want. You know what I mean? Walk around our city trying to compensate for they want to feel bad because they in Philly. You know what I mean? We don't cry and complain about none of that stuff, man. We don't cry and complain about none of that stuff, man. We actually treat the opposing team's fan base with open arms. Every Philly game I've ever been to, yeah, you're going to get booed. You're going to get heckled. But you're coming to an away game. This Philly, we different. I'll give you an example. Week 3, I was in Washington. Washington versus the Philadelphia Eagles. We was running through that building screaming, "Fly, Eagles, fly." E-A-G-L. It was different, man. It was different. So I don't know what y'all doing, y'all other spots or something like that. But I can assure you this, ladies and gentlemen, that Eagles fans ain't going to watch no woman get pushed down and don't stick up for her. You know what I mean? That's just not going to happen. So, you know, believe what you want. If you were scared, you should have stayed home. You know what I mean? If you're scared, go to bed. But don't sit up here and make up things and make up wild theories and all of this stuff. Now Sports Illustrated reporting on it, TMZ Sports. Now the story growing legs. They're not reporting on how y'all coming up here disrespecting the statue, though. We don't go to y'all city and disrespect landmarks. We don't do stuff like that. We go to y'all city, we go to the game, and we go home. You know what I'm saying? Like, stop it, man. Cut it out, man. But let me know what y'all think in the comments, man. We're going to definitely start spinning up the content. Really, this has been a week of, for me, it's been a week of relaxing and soaking in the moment. It really just hit me yesterday when I saw the Eagles was wearing the green jerseys. You know what I mean? When I saw the green jerseys being stitched on and when I saw where we was really at, that's when it really dawned on me that, you know, we them ones, man. We in the Super Bowl, man. We're going to have that logo on our chest. So that was really starting to settle in and soak in. Now I'm watching tape of the Chiefs. I'm watching, you know, ways we can exploit these guys. And all that's going to be all compiled into the next couple videos. What I think about the Chiefs, how we can beat the Chiefs, why I feel like we're going to beat the Chiefs, all that. Oh, it is what it is, man. You know what I mean? Patrick Mahomes not 100%. You know what I mean? We here to do work, and do work we shall. Till next time.